Maurizio is an old friend of ours. He's a specialist in gynecology, and he works 24 hours per day, because you know, when you are in gynecology department, also because the kids, they want to be born in by night, especially. So his pineal gland is completely fucked up. Che la tua ghiandola pineale è partita. And what is nice from Maurizio is first that he has really a huge experience, daily experience with all the different type of gynecologist patients, and he developed a huge experience in hypofertility. So I think that that part of our seminar will be very, very interesting. Very possibly it will be the two first hours of tomorrow. And besides to be an important specialist in gynecology, Maurizio, he is that one you say you call a good person. He is a very sensitive man, and really he takes care of all his patients with love, attention, with the goal first of all not to provoke any damage, and helping them to suffer less or to have the joy to have a kid, no? To have a baby. So the same will be with you. Maurizio, I know that during his seminars he gives everything he knows, he will share with you, and please, like with me, don't hesitate to stop him to ask any question you want. I could say many other things, but I stop here. Okay. So I know that Maurizio speaks just a little English, so he will say something to you, and then he will speak Italian and I will translate for you.
Yes, of course, dear colleague. I want to extend you my greetings, and thank you for your attention. I beg your pardon because my exposition will be in Italian, but that we are lucky, because the exposition will be translated by Dr. Pera, who is a great teacher and a great friend, and he will help me to explain better what I could say. So now we can begin, and thank you again for your assistance, attention.
My assistance. Okay, good.
Good. Nuove prospettive in ginecologia, la medicina delle basse dosi.
It's written.
No. È importante sottolineare un aspetto, le basse dosi.
It's important to underline the goal, that is the use of low dose of drugs.
Perché? Per dirla con Shakespeare.
Okay, this is a quote from Shakespeare, and it's a quote that Maurizio loves so much.
Okay, sì, lo amo molto, ma cosa mi fa pensare questo verso? Mi fa pensare alla nostra capacità di comprendere la realtà e di capire anche cose che non possiamo vedere o sentire o toccare o misurare, ma esse esistono.
What he likes of this quote is that the meaning is that even though something is not possible to be understood right now, we have to think that something you are not in a position to explain very well, anyway, it exists, and we have to take under consideration this aspect.
È quello che ci permette di fare questo meraviglioso strumento che è la medicina fisiologica di regolazione.
And Maurizio defined the physiological regulating medicine as a wonderful tool for every doctor.
Tutte le volte che devo introdurre una mia lezione parlando di medicina fisiologica di regolazione sono in difficoltà perché ci sarebbero troppe cose da dire.
The only difficulty for Maurizio is that he is so willing to tell you everything, but there are too many things. So that's the only difficulty. So he had to choose the most important ones.
Anche perché ne ha parlato tantissimo in terra questa mattina e sarebbe difficile superarlo.
He says that it's very difficult to speak up after me, but it's not true, so no, it's not true. It's not easy to speak up after a so handsome man.
Soltanto tre cose. La medicina fisiologica di regolazione ci permette di capire tre cose. Di capire come l'equilibrio del nostro essere, del vivente, sia dovuto ad una serie di processi in continuo movimento, spesso che si bilanciano a vicenda.
Okay, he wants to underline, highlight three aspects. First, that the physiology is something continuously moving, where cells control each other.
Perché questi processi si verifichino, ci deve essere una continua comunicazione tra le parti.
Okay, all these processes are dynamic and they need a very good communication between the parts. So the concept of dynamic physiology is what Maurizio wants to underline.
L'omeostasi è frutto di continui processi di bilanciamento reciproco.
Always we like to refer to the concept of homeostasis that we have spoken about this morning.
E per garantire l'omeostasi abbiamo bisogno di informazione continua. Le cellule, gli apparati, gli organi continuano a parlarsi.
And to keep a good homeostasis, it's absolutely mandatory that all the systems, the organ, the tissues, the cells, continuously talk each other.
E attraverso delle molecole segnale.
The only way for the cells to talk each other is using the signaling molecules.
Molecole segnale piccole, molto piccole, ma che per questo non esistono, anche se non sono tangibili e misurabili con le unità di misura consuete.
They are very small molecules in a very little concentration, and even though sometimes you don't see them, they exist.
Questo concetto ci permette di arrivare all'idea di Pnei, all'idea dell'organismo come un'entità integrata.
We like to think of the human organism as an integrated unit where the concept of PNEI is dominant.
Per abitudine pensiamo alla psiche e al corpo, al sistema nervoso, endocrino e immunitario come entità separate.
We are used to think of mind and body or central nervous system, immune system, endocrine system as isolated systems. No, that's wrong. They are completely interconnected.
In sincronia, una cellula è in grado di parlare istantaneamente con tutte le altre cellule dell'organismo.
And Maurizio is introducing a new concept of synchronism. That means every cell is able to speak to all the other cells.
Ma abbiamo detto anche troppo. Passiamo direttamente alla componente. Dottor Per avrà parlato senz'altro molto dell'infiammazione, ha parlato tantissimo stamattina,
sì.
La vedremo applicata nelle singole patologie o nei focus sulle patologie e sulla clinica.
Maurizio will not speak about inflammation since I already have spoken about that, but he will refer continuously to the therapy of inflammation since many of the diseases are inflammatory diseases.
Infatti passiamo dalla medicina fisiologica di regolazione alla clinica.
So let's go very pragmatic and let's go to the clinic.
Ho cercato di
assolutamente. Yeah.
La clinica. In ginecologia i sintomi più diffusi più riferiti dalle pazienti, comuni a diversi quadri patologici, che sono il dolore pelvico, le alterazioni dell'asse, successivamente le alterazioni dell'asse endocrino e i disturbi, le alterazioni, le difficoltà della riproduzione.
So the most common disturbances related to the gynecology specialization are chronic pelvic pain, infertility and alteration of the endocrine axis.
Ma al giorno d'oggi ormai c'è una visione che ci permette, sostenuta anche dai dati della letteratura, c'è un consenso a considerare il sistema immunitario come giocatore in campo nel sostenere e contribuire sia alla regolazione sia alle patologie.
Even though part of these diseases are supported by endocrine disorders, nowadays the concept is that you have to act also on the immune system to regulate the endocrine system.
Perché il sistema endocrino è solo una parte dell'intera asse pneo.
It's just one part of the PNEI, the endocrine system, and you always have to act on the entire network.
Pertanto, noi, grazie alla medicina fisiologica di regolazione, siamo in grado di capire e di utilizzare dei farmaci che ci permettono di lavorare sul sistema endocrino, lavorare sull'apparato, sugli apparati ginecologici, ma interagendo con l'intero asse della pelle.
So even though with some medications you will act primarily on the organ of the endocrine system or of the female genital system, actually you will see in the PRM medications, Guna medications, that always they have some ingredients on the central nervous system, other immune system, other endocrine system. Is an integrated activity.
E questa è la PNEI. Scolasticamente, e siamo legati a questa visione scolastica, la concepiamo come un asse dall'alto in basso.
This is a slide you know very well. Normally we consider the PNEI network as a top-down axis.
Ma in realtà il dialogo è continuo e va dall'alto al basso. Non esiste più un centro, non esiste più una periferia. Ogni cellula è informata e reagisce e parla con le altre.
But it's true that it's top-down oriented, but also down-top oriented. And it's important to know that, once again, every cell can interfere with all the other cells.
No, sorry. E queste sono le attrici, gli attori del nostro crossover. Le cellule del nostro corpo.
So, just to use a few words, the concept of crosstalk, intercellular crosstalk.
Che utilizzano molecole segnali.
And since they use signaling molecules, maybe we can reproduce this crosstalk with our medications.
Oh, sorry. Questa è, riproduce schematicamente il rapporto tra il sistema nervoso centrale, la regolazione endocrina che passa attraverso un regista, l'ipofisi, e l'azione di tutte le risposte di tutti gli organi dell'apparato endocrino.
This is a slide that you know very well, and it shows the relationship between central nervous system, the main actor of the endocrine system, that is the anterior hypophysis, the hypophysal tropins, and the target organs. You know very well, it's a classic.
You know very well, I will be fast. But always there is a feedback.
There is a continuous reciprocal feedback.
Per ottenere l'albero della vita.
That's the tree of life of Expo in Milan.
Okay. Tutto questo per comprendere perché usiamo ormoni low dose.
That's important. That was a very important premise to understand why we are in the position to use hormones, but in low dose.
Low dose. Perché ormai la letteratura convenzionale presenta numerosi lavori che sottolineano l'importanza delle molecole low dose nella regolazione endocrina.
Maurizio is saying that it's not only our concept as a PRM Academy that want to use low dose hormones, but a lot of papers in the field of gynecology are speaking in terms of low dose hormones. So there is something common in all the scientific environments.
Sì, ma noi abbiamo una chiave di interpretazione e questo ci dà.
But we have something more that is the possibility to understand how to use these low dose hormones, not in terms of hormonal replacement therapy.
Yes. Questo è quello che abbiamo detto prima. Addirittura molti lavori sottolineano la possibilità di utilizzare gonadotropine low dose.
A lot of papers are about the use of even gonadotropins low dose.
Nelle procedure di fecondazione assistita.
When you are you are using in English medical assisted
MFAI.
IVF. Okay, IVF.
Okay. And questo è un Cochrane database del 2013 e quindi esamina un numero elevato, esattamente 52 lavori sull'impiego di gonadotropine low dose nelle tecniche di fecondazione assistita al posto dell'FSH, tanto per non far nomi con altro. Cioè è importante questo.
That's very interesting. It is a Cochrane database that show the possibility to use low dose gonadotropine instead of FSH in assisted reproductive technique. So it's not only something of PRM.
Abbiamo appunto espresso questo. Questo si riferisce a una citazione che si riferisce appunto al lavoro.
This is part of that Cochrane.
Ma quale dovrebbe essere il razionale di impiego della terapia ormonale secondo la medicina fisiologica di regolazione?
Let's go to see what we have to do.
Allora, non dobbiamo pensare a una terapia puramente sostitutiva.
Our therapy is not an hormonal replacement therapy as in conventional pharmacology.
Perché i farmaci low dose sono in grado di stimolare la risposta autonoma e la regolazione dei centri per riportare all'equilibrio i processi che si siano sotto o sopra regolati.
Beh, the first difference with the hormonal replacement therapy is that using low dose hormones you are stimulating the endocrine cells to produce their own hormones able to reestablish the balance, the hormonal balance. So it's not something from out, but it's something from inside.
Inside, yes. Perché, come abbiamo detto prima, ricordiamo il sistema, non è necessario ovviamente che lo traduci perché lo vedono, il sistema endocrino è solo una parte dell'intero albero europeo, il sistema endocrino. E prova della relazione tra il sistema endocrino e il sistema immunitario è osservare come ci sia una azione degli ormoni sessuali femminili, delle gonadotropine, degli ormoni sessuali, estrogeno e progesterone, sulle popolazioni linfocitarie.
In this slide you can see how hormones are able to interfere also with the immune system. In this case, the female sexual hormones are able to stimulate TH1. That's the reason why the prevalence of autoimmune diseases is higher in female sex.
E il cortisolo, che può avere un'azione inibente a sua volta sugli ormoni di equilibrio, ha un'azione opposta.
It's interesting also to see that cortisol, which is able to downregulate female sexual hormones directly, is able to inhibit TH1. So it's really interesting, the cross regulation even for hormones.
P is psiconeuro, P di psiconeuro. E l'ormone chiave per entrare nel mondo della psiconeuro è la melatonina.
Okay, so we don't like to speak in terms of the endocrine system only, but always in terms of psychoneuroendocrine system. And the most important neurohormone to manage the PNN of the acronym PNEI is melatonin. We are a little obsessive with melatonin, but it's really it's really the pivot of every therapy according to Maurizio.
Okay, you all know that voi tutti sapete che è prodotta dall'epifisi, segue il ritmo circadiano e ha un ruolo cruciale nella funzione riproduttiva.
It's you know, it's produced by the pineal gland. And everybody think of melatonin in terms of hypoinducent substance. No, I add something. It is a very strong TH1 stimulator, and very important literature show the role played by melatonin in hypofertility and in the female reproductive function in general. So keep in mind melatonin.
Vedremo in dettaglio questo aspetto.
We will see everything about that.
La melatonina svolge un ruolo importantissimo nella regolazione e nella liberazione dei fattori di rilascio delle gonadotropine all'introduzione nel circolo portale ipofisario.
Why is so important? According to the physiology, you maybe will remember that melatonin is crucial to stimulate and release the release of gonadotropin releasing hormone into the pituitary portal circulation. So in an indirect way, when you want to stimulate GnRH, think of melatonin.
E la melatonina è in grado di interagire con il sistema immunitario attraverso un sovrastimolo delle popolazioni di TH1.
So you have seen how melatonin, that is a neurohormone, is able to talk to the endocrine system, releasing GnRH, but also with the immune system upregulating TH1. Really, he's the director of orchestra of the entire PNEI network.
È interessante rapidamente osservare che la melatonina presenta nell'arco del mese, non solo della giornata, ma del mese, due picchi. Nella fase follicolare precoce, regolatoria, e nella fase luteale, tarda fase luteale, quella che dovrebbe essere, in caso di fecondazione, la fase dell'annidamento.
That's really interesting also for me, I didn't know that. Everybody knows about the pulsatility of melatonin by night.
During the day.
Okay, during the day, circadian rhythm. But it's very interesting to observe the pulsatility of melatonin during the menstrual cycle. We have two spikes. some days before the 14-day ovulation and in the late luteal phase, when we need the perfect condition to the anidamento in English, I don't know, okay, for the embryon to stay well in there. So, interesting, some days before, some days late. If you don't have the homeostatic concentration of melatonin, that can be one of the several cases of I'm not pregnant.
Yes.
Not me, but my women.
No.
I have a big experience. Maurizio is underlining the importance of to restore and respect the pulsatility. Not boom, one shot. Pulsatility, the physiology. That's something important for Maurizio.
Anche questo concetto è un regalo, la comprensione è un regalo della medicina fisiologica di regolazione.
And Maurizio says, yes, okay, all these references, but we understood that, especially thanks to the PRF.
Ruola, gioca un ruolo importante per l'impianto embrionale.
It plays a role in the oocyte maturation, but also in the embryo implantation, what we said before.
E si riduce in donne aged.
And melatonin goes down
in età avanzata.
During elderly.
Nell'età riproduttiva, nelle fasi più avanzate dell'età riproduttiva.
Okay, during the late period of reproductive age, I mean after 40 years old, goes down.
Ovviamente oltre che in casi di alterazioni patologiche.
Always, and always when you have a pathology in the hypothalamus, hypophysis, gonads, asks.
È stata anche suggerita dalla letteratura la opportunità di amministrare melatonina nelle procedure di fecondazione assistita.
Also literature is speaking, it's a very recent reference, 2011, about the use, the opportunity of melatonin during MAF.
Ma c'è anche il sistema immunitario.
Yeah, but we have to consider also the immune system.
Purtroppo io sono molto dispiaciuto di dover settorializzare, però da questo approccio a settori arriveremo a comporre una musica armonica.
Okay. We have highlighted the role of the neurohormone melatonin for the P and the N of the PNEI network. And Maurizio is sorry that he's speaking in a very rigid way, PNEI. But by a scholastic point of view, this is the path we have to do. But you will see that everything will be considered as a unit in a very short time.
Lì, conosciamo molto bene.
They know everything about the eye.
Molti autori, e ripeto, noi abbiamo la chiave per interpretare, forse non è presunzione.
Okay, several authors speaks about the use of cytokines, but for us PRM people, it's very easy to understand what is written in this light.
Molti autori sottolineano la possibilità di usare la misurazione del pool delle citochine come marcatori clinici e prognostici di tutte le patologie pelviche, in particolare dell'endometriosi.
Many gynecology departments in the world are thinking to use markers of inflammation and immune disorders as markers for chronic pelvic pathology and especially endometriosis. Yesterday I was in Rome at the Policlinico Gemelli speaking with one of the most important gynecologists in the field of endometriosis, because we are performing a study using anti-interleukin 1, interleukin 10 and progesterone in endometriosis. And they know very well that in endometriosis, interleukin 1 is very, very high, and it speaks with the endocrine system making a mess. So absolutely, they are focusing on the attention of the immune markers.
E questa è una cosa molto importante. È un ospedale universitario di elevato livello, gemelli di Roma.
Yeah, no, it's very important that also that university is coming to us.
È quello che abbiamo appunto per inciso detto 2015. Le pazienti, beh, voi tutti siete in grado
di... Yeah, what is important is that...
La citazione non è il concetto che...
It's a very update reference, 2015. Patients with endometriosis has high level of 1, 6 and TNF-alpha. And interleukin 1 beta and 6 can be used as markers to make a diagnosis of endometriosis. So, everybody is speaking our language. That's the sense of what Maurizio wants to say.
L'impiego di molecole biologiche è ormai accettato e concepito da numerosissimi autori. L'uso di molecole low dose è in grado di essere, funziona perché è in grado di essere consonant, in armonia, in sintonia con le concentrazioni che si trovano a svolgere un ruolo a livello dei recettori.
With our low dose medications, using the same concentration of the physiological concentration in healthy condition in our body, we are very resonant with what physiologically happens in our body.
Ed è dimostrato da tutte le ricerche che e i lavori che appaiono in letteratura sull'azione farmacologica delle nanoconcentrazioni.
I show you already some papers. Yeah, about low dose signaling molecule.
So,
what is interesting is that other people is reaching the same results we are reaching. So really, we can say that the low dose pharmacology is becoming the mainstream pharmacology.
E qui ribadiamo quello che abbiamo espresso prima.
You know very well that we use low dose cytokines in order to enhance the capability of the receptors to bind a hormone, for instance, or a cytokine.
Perché ci deve essere appunto una risonanza, non è la quantità, ma la risonanza e la sintonia della concentrazione fisiologica come quella presente a livello recettoriale.
Okay, we already spoken about the physiology of this mechanism.
Abbiamo numerosissime evidenze di letteratura che le citochine rientrano nel gioco del dolore pelvico, di tutte le sindromi correlate al dolore pelvico nell'endometriosi e nell'endometriosi.
As well as hormones, also cytokines are involved, literature says that, in pelvic pain syndrome, endometriosis and infertility. So once again, we have to think in terms of the entire PNEI network, not only in terms of cytokines or hormones.
Ma noi siamo in grado di interagire anche con la stessa metodica sulla parte immunitaria dell'asse della pelle.
We are able once again to act on all the three parts of the PNEI axis.
Sia endocrino che immunitario. Abbiamo a disposizione uno strumento validissimo, importantissimo. È molto interessante il grafico, si passa dall'immunità alla psiche. Immunità, psiche.
Maurizio, as a gynecologist, loves so much this medication, Guna Fem, because it's expression of how to act on the entire PNEI axis. And Maurizio says we can use this medication when we want to start from the immune system to reach the psychoneural part of the axis, or we can start from a psycho disturbances and affecting the immune system. So it's really nice to use in both the directions, psychosomatic or somatopsychic direction.
E noi abbiamo, vero, melatonina per la fase neuropsico.
Important, we have the melatonin that already said is the director of the orchestra of the entire network.
E siamo in grado di interagire sulla parte somatica, endocrina e immunitaria attraverso gli ormoni in low dose, gli organi che producono gli ormoni, e nella Guna Fem, per noi ha un altro nome, sono rappresentati tutti gli organi endocrini ed infine la chiave per entrare nel mondo del sistema immunitario, il timo.
Okay. You can observe that there is a prevalence of Swiss organ preparations able to stimulate the hormones produced by every target organ, hypophysis, hypophysis, and so on. But you can also observe thymus gland, that is the key to enter into the immune, to land in the immune planet. So P, N, E, and I are all of them respected.
In questa diapositiva vediamo ancora meglio come un sistema solare ordinatamente ruota e quali sono gli effetti di ciascuno dei componenti di questo perfetto e armonico sistema solare.
Guna Fem can be considered a referring point in every gynecologist disease because it's really very complete, and every ingredient is very balanced in relationship with the other remedies.
Se noi leggiamo le funzioni attribuite a ciascuna componente del farmaco, vediamo come, a cominciare dalla componente psiconeuro, siano comprese tutte le possibili situazioni di alterazione.
If you read the action mechanism for every component, you can see that starting from the psychoneural alteration, arriving to the immune system, you can balance the entire organism.
Anche perché ciascuna di queste scatole, ciascuna di queste box, non esprime una funzione separata, ma sono alterazioni e regolazioni che sono in continuo bilanciamento, perché vedremo come le condizioni di stress o alterazioni della tiroide sono in grado di interagire con il metabolismo attraverso l'insulina.
Okay,
for example.
Yeah, it's a little difficult to translate.
Difficult to translate, but what I mean?
okay. In English, go.
Catch it.
No one of these boxes is an iron, but it exprimes the relation between every part of the organism.
If you act on thyroid gland, you are acting indirectly on the pancreas and so on. So the fact that all the Swiss organ preparation are inside of this medication ensure a balanced activity, very balanced activity on the PNEI axis. Okay, but
se
we are stressing very well.
Questa diapositiva può diventare un libro di fisiopatologia.
Okay, is a book of physiopathology, the composition of Guna Fem. Okay.
E quali sono gli ormoni che abbiamo a disposizione nella medicina fisiologica di regolazione?
Besides Gunafem, that is a multi-component, multi-target medication, we also have single hormones, and this is the list of the single hormones.
Abbiamo ormoni in low dose per ogni organo endocrino.
We have the correspondent hormones for every endocrine organ, hypothalamus, hypophysis, and so on.
E, ovviamente la parte principale, la parte delle ume, è svolta dall'ipofisi.
Hypophysis has so many hormones, so you see a lot.
Ma vedremo, come abbiamo avuto esperienza, come abbiamo esperienza nella pratica clinica, che ciascun ormone può essere utilizzato anche singolarmente o utilizzato in concerto.
Okay, it's possible to use a single hormone or even better to combine different hormones because always there is a reciprocal feedback among hormones.
E questa è la tavola. Questo tavolo ci esprime appunto gli ormoni che sono a nostra disposizione. Qui ci sono ancora le diluizioni, ovviamente, 6 decimali. Ma che cosa è interessante di questa tavola?
This is for hormones, the same table we studied this morning for cytokines. So it's possible to enhance the activity of an hormone when you have a deficiency using the same hormones. But even more interesting is the regulation of the excess of an hormone using the opposing hormone according to the negative physiological feedback.
La contrapposizione, estrogeni, progesterone.
For instance, if you want to downregulate progesterone, you have to use beta-estradiol. And on the contrary, if you have a hyperestrogenism, you can control the hyperestrogenism with progesterone. That's what we do in endometriosis, in fact, for instance, and so on. So it's physiology.
Infatti, lo strumento è la capacità di bilanciare l'asse della mente, trattare i sintomi e non dimenticare quello che è il campo principale dove si gioca la storia, la battaglia, la vita del sistema immunitario, la matrice, quella che ai miei tempi veniva presentata come un tessuto di riempimento e di sostegno.
Maurizio is referring to the triangle of the therapy that we have seen this morning. He is underlining even Maurizio the importance of the drainage, that is the main tissue we have where everything happens.
La liberazione dalle tossine parte dal drenaggio della matrice, che è una fase importantissima e altrettanto importante che le altre due del triangolo terapeutico.
It's important as well as the other ones. So please don't never forget Guna Matrix and Guna Lympho and so on. Okay, we haven't seen this slide, so.
About this.
Yeah. Okay, we have studied this.
Another book of pathophysiology.
It's another book of pathophysiology. I see that Maurizio underlined DHEA. No?
Dihidroepiandrosterone. Dihidroepiandrosterone, importantissimo per il sostegno dell'immunità, della funzione sessuale. Qui l'avevo. Però ha un'azione trofica su tutte le strutture. È un'azione anche di drenaggio dalle tossine, per esempio, della funzione ipotalamica.
Okay. In Guna Matrix, Maurizio is underlining the hydroepiandrosterone. As a gynecologist, he says that's great for several activities of the hydroepiandrosterone. Is a precursor of steroid hormones, sexual hormones. But DHEA also has a trophic activity, and it also has a drainant activity against hepatopancreatic
function.
Yeah, it sustains the liver and pancreas activity. So it's something very complex. In terms of gynecology, to have DHEA is great.
Yeah.
In Guna Matrix, it's a complex activity.
Come una linfo di cui avrai parlato tu senz'altro questa mattina, e sono due strumenti fondamentali per il drenaggio a livello della matrice dei connettivi, e non dimentichiamo che esiste la matrice anche negli organi.
Esatto. Maurizio is saying that in his practice he always refers to matrix and linfo because it's according to his experience is important to drain the matrix. And the matrix is inside of the organs, so it's important to support them.
Passiamo a clinica.
So these are the main tools that Maurizio will use to speak about syndromes.
Okay. Amenorrhea. La sindrome dell'amenorrhea. L'amenorrhea può essere causata, come sapete, da alterazioni a livello ipotalamico, da disturbi dell'ipofisi o da un'alterazione della risposta dalla periferia al centro, un feedback inappropriato.
Several causes for amenorrhea can be primary hypothalamic or pituitary, but also interesting is the direction bottom top. So an appropriate hormone feedback from periphery to the center.
E che cosa significano in termini di capacità informativa di crosstalk secondo i principi play? Possono significare un'alterazione delle molecole segnale?
Can be related all these three alteration to an alteration in signaling molecules, especially neurotransmitters?
La risposta è sì. L'alterazione delle molecole segnale è una delle cause più frequenti di disturbi che possono essere anche poco sintomatici, ma che si andranno a accumulare nell'arco del tempo.
Even though your patient don't have yet symptoms, the alteration in signaling molecules is at the base of this type of dysfunctions. So it's important to recover the physiology.
Dal nostro punto di vista è molto importante una recente scoperta, perché molte vie neuroendocrine sono trovano il centro di regolazione a livello dell'ipotalamo, come noi sappiamo.
Especially is important the role played by hypothalamus as a central part for the control of reproductive function.
Infatti c'è, è stato recentemente scoperto nel 2005-2006 un'area dell'ipotalamo collocata a livello del nucleo arcuato, una popolazione di neuroni che vengono chiamati neuroni KND.
Perché è importante questo? Così?
Perché, eccolo qua.
Ah, ok. Recently some cells have been isolated in the hypothalamus and they are very important in the regulation between central nervous system and endocrine system because
sono i neuroni che liberano la chiespertina. La chiespertina che pare essere riconosciuta come una, la più importante chiave per interagire con la liberazione di gonadotropine.
Ok, in this part of in these cells of hypothalamus recently has been isolated a protein named kisspeptin, that is very important for the release of gonadotropins like LH and FSH.
Per la corretta liberazione dei fattori di rilascio.
For the right release of releasing hormone, hypothalamic releasing hormones.
Con la corretta pulsatilità.
With the right pulsatility. So it seems that all the mess is provoked by this kisspeptin.
Scusatemi se stresso questo concetto.
He wants to stress this concept because he's dedicated a lot of time of his life to kisspeptin.
Perché queste sono le molecole, sono della stessa famiglia. Vabbè, questo è un aneddoto, ma pare, secondo alcuni studiosi, che questo neurotrasmettitore venga liberato in occasione del primo bacio, per questo anche la
mia. Ah, ok, this kisspeptin that is in some cells of the hypothalamus is called kisspeptin because it seems that he has is released when you give the first kiss. So it's important to kiss each other because it regulates the pulsatility of the gonadotropins.
Yes.
Can be important. Interesting. Didn't know.
È un lavoro dell'Università di Pittsburgh, non ho detto io.
It's the University of Pittsburgh.
Okay. E la scoperta della chisspeptina come chiave di regolazione centrale delle gonadotropine ha condotto a una nuova capacità di comprendere la regolazione neuroendocrina della riproduzione umana.
So the concept Maurizio want to stress with you is that not it is not only important the GnRH in the regulation of the endocrine system, especially for the genital system, but there is something upper at the hypothalamus level, and now we know which is this controller. This controller is the kisspeptin. It is absolutely important to regulate the release and the pulsatility. So not only important GnRH, but something upper, kisspeptin.
E queste sono le riferimenti bibliografici.
These are some references about the importance of kisspeptin in relationship with GnRH.
E questo è la corretta pulsatilità dell'LH, grazie a una corretta liberazione del neurotrasmettitore monte.
If we have a right quantity of this neurotransmitter kisspeptin, the pulsatility of LH will be perfect. So instead of to think only in terms of LH, why not to think of something upper regulating the LH? Till now we were convinced it was the GnRH. Now we know that there is something upper that is the kisspeptin. Maybe we can do something interesting on kisspeptin.
Vi prego di osservare la variazione di intensità dei picchi non differisce. L'intensità in quantità e differisce la cadenza, la frequenza, la lunghezza.
Ah, okay.
Nell'arco di ore, stiamo parlando nell'arco di ore.
Okay, kisspeptin doesn't interfere with the quantity of LH, but with the pulsatility. So it's maybe more important for the control of pulsatility.
This is the intensity of LH in overtime delay, amenorrhea hypothalamica, obesity is not different from a normal pulsatile state
looking at
okay, so you can observe that the problem is not the quantity of LH but the pulsatility. Who controls the pulsatility? His peptin. So the key to regulate the homeostasis of LH is not something interfering with the quantity but with the pulsatility. That's very interesting.
Io mi chiedo a voi colleghi, quante volte noi chiediamo alle nostre pazienti il dosaggio ormonale dell'LH?
And Maurizio says, how many times we ask the dosage of LH?
But when we have a result. Because the variability is in 12 hours.
Yeah.
When we get a result, we can't know if we are here.
Okay, it says it doesn't make any...
different the pulsatility.
Okay, that doesn't make any sense to ask only for a dosage of LH. Because if you take the blood here or here, it's different. What is important is the dynamics of the release. So it's important to ask for the dynamic release. Yeah.
Just if you are testing for the markers or the levels, is it day 3 or day 21 of the cycle that you get the better results?
Speak slowly.
If you're testing for the hormone levels,
yeah,
in blood tests,
yeah,
is it, and for the biomarkers,
yeah,
IL-1, would you do it on day 3 or day 21 of the female cycle?
Okay, so quindi quando tu devi fare un test per capire i biomarkers come l'LH okay durante il ciclo?
Normalmente io chiedo due test di normally I ask for two or three tests every summer hour un giorno dopo l'altro.
Okay, always
for three days consecutive. For 3 days.
No, dimmelo in italiano.
In italiano, per 3 giorni consecutivi.
Okay, he asked for a blood test for 3 consecutive days, for instance, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, but always at the same time, but at least 3 days.
Because I think we must look at the difference, the delta, not the quantità.
What is important is not the total amount of LH, but the delta, the difference between the days, but always at the same time, because you can see the circadian rhythm. What is important is that this circadian rhythm is controlled by T-speptin. So act on that.
Oh, sorry. Adesso gratifico la componente Guna.
Okay, now we speak about our products.
Noi possediamo un analogo della T-speptin.
We have something that is exactly the same of T-speptin, even though in terms of amino acids it's different. But the role played by beta endorphin is the same of T-speptin. That's interesting.
Perché appartiene alla stessa famiglia. Ovviamente non è T-speptin, ma la beta endorfina appartiene alla famiglia delle dinorfine.
La T-speptina?
Beta
endorfina?
Sì, okay. Beta endorfina fa parte della famiglia delle, ed è quanto di più affine è possibile avere come strumento farmacologico in questo momento.
Beta endorfina e T-speptin are part of the same family and it's the most similar in terms of activity and structure to T-speptin. So when we want to reestablish the right pulsatility, we have available Guna beta endorphin. You are saying that Guna beta endorphin is like to give the first kiss. Okay.
Yes. Se posso essere confidenziale, tanto siamo.
He wants to be very confidential with you.
Prima o poi, o stasera o domani.
We will kiss each other.
Parleremo, porterò una casistica che giudico interessante sul trattamento dell'infertilità.
Maybe today or tomorrow, Maurizio will show you a very interesting casuistics about hypofertility and infertility.
The treatment of infertility.
Io non sono un ospedale. Non ho 1000 pazienti all'anno.
He doesn't have thousands of patients with hypofertility, but is significant anyway.
Però ormai dopo tre anni la casistica comincia ad essere valutabile.
Yeah.
Soprattutto con l'aiuto. My casistic began to be a bit valutabile.
Evaluable.
Grazie anche tanto also to the help of other colleagues.
Yeah, what is happening is that his personal casistic is improving because all the doctors who attend Maurizio's seminar are trying with their patients the treatment for hypofertility, and we are collecting all the data now. So it's a multi-center observational study nowadays.
Yes.
So interesting that beta endorphin plays the same role of kisspeptin.
Ma stavo ho fatto questo inciso e mi vedi inciso.
I don't know.
Because in the second, in the new cases, about from 1 year, I began to give beta endorphin. Insieme a
in italiano
insieme a come si dice
together with
melatonin, but di questo okay. Part of those really
why Maurizio said something about hypofertility, because in the last cases he's treated, he insert in the therapeutic protocol Maurizio will present to you also beta endorphin with this goal to reestablish release and pulsatility of gonadotropics, obviously.
Terapia della amenorrea primaria.
This is therapy according Maurizio's experience on primary amenorrhea.
Abbiamo parlato talmente tanto che la terapia nasce da sola.
Yes, it's we have stressed some concept that the therapy is consequential.
And the new entry, beta endorphin, I suggest.
Okay, so since we want to work on the entire PNEI axis, starting from the P and the N, melatonin and beta endorphin are mandatory, absolutely. Now we know also why beta endorphin, because it is the same of kisspeptin.
La componente endocrina.
Obviously there is an endocrine dysfunction.
We can find in Guna fem all these.
And it's an alteration among pineal gland, hypothalamus, and corpus luteum, and they are ingredients of Gunafem, so Gunafem is always very complete in these terms.
And the drainage in the matrix, che grazie a Dr. Perra conosciamo tutti molto bene.
Yes, we are in love, all of us, but you can observe that matrix and Fem are very, very present in the most part of the protocols. And then we change some parts in a very specific way. How long? Excuse me. Please.
I'm just wondering, reasons for high prolactin levels.
Sorry, to
prolactin levels?
Hyperprolactin.
Ah, I've seen
yeah,
some kind.
Melatonin is the opposite hormone of prolactin. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Prolactin.
Come senz'altro avrete avuto modo. Yes. Often there is hyperprolactinemia.
Very often, yeah, very often in primary amenorrhea there is an hyperprolactinemia. Think that the prolactin is one of the stress hormones. So it's typical of amenorrhea in women under stress.
Yeah.
For instance, one time I read about a epidemiological study about the women employees in Milan staying for more than 6 hours in front of the computer screen. All of them had level of prolactin much higher than the normal. The level of stress was so high that they had hyperprolactinemia and the most part of them amenorrhea due to hyperprolactinemia. So it's absolutely interesting the use of melatonin as opposing hormone of prolactin.
If we remember what we stressed before about melatonin, is it in opposition with prolactin?
Yes, it's the opposing hormones able to rebalance the.
And vorrei chiedere. 50 anni fa, 50 years ago, la nostra vita, per chi c'era, per chi era bambino, facciamo 40 anni fa, il nostro giorno era scandito da così tante ore di luce come adesso.
When you were a kid, like for them 10 years ago, he's speaking about himself 50 years ago, it's not true. What's your question? How many?
Quante ore di luce ci sono? Quante ore di luce abbiamo noi, luce artificiale?
The problem that in comparison with 50 years ago, now we have much more hours of artificial light. So it's provoking something not nice. Yeah. Disrupting melatonin.
Quante ore di televisione c'erano?
How many hours of TV, but how many hours of computers now? Yeah. So you are disrupting the pulsatility of melatonin.
L'infertilità, I problemi di infertilità sono notevolmente cresciuti.
Hypofertility now, in comparison with 50 years ago, it's dramatically higher. Disease related to stress, but not stress like something that you cannot touch. Stress is too much light, too much computer, too much exact cell phone, or I don't know. And not enough kisses. We like sex. If you want to stay well, have sex. Free love. Absolutely. I'm completely convinced. How do you feel after sex? Well, you men want to sleep, you women want another orgasm. That's a problem for us, but anyway, we stay well. Because of your oxytocin oriented, and we are prolactin oriented after orgasm, so it's a problem. So melatonin for us after orgasm. Yeah, perfect. So take melatonin and you will have a very good performance.
then you ain't like
that. Okay, I will take. Do we have some beta endorphin here for tonight? It's interesting, yeah, because you want to have a mimic action for kisspeptin with beta endorphin. So, Maurizio, you recommend the combination of melatonin and beta endorphin usually.
My protocol of against infertility, the treatment of infertility.
Perfect.
Now I'm using about
that's really very smart. I didn't know about that.
And as you can see, I'm ignoring the telephone.
Yeah, because it's something just to relax. Something is happening in our environment because since Maurizio is performing lectures, speaking about hypofertility here in Italy, we are receiving a lot, but really a lot of phone calls from colleagues that are referring to us the positive results of this therapy for primary amenorrhea, but especially for hypofertility. So maybe we found the right balance between all these medications. Anyway, that's interesting, primary amenorrhea. Which is the prevalence of primary amenorrhea? L'incidenza di amenorrhea nelle donne italiane?
Sta crescendo. Non ti saprei. siamo in fascia di età 14-18 anni, sicuramente sta crescendo. Siamo sul 3-4%, sicuramente
5%.
Ah, in young,
women, the prevalence of primary amenorrhea is very dramatically increasing. In Italy we are between 4% and 8% of young women, and to solve the problem, Maurizio is saying you have to go on for long time with this therapy, sometimes for years.
I don't know in other countries, but in Italy, due cose. La menorrea primaria e il menarca precoce.
In Italy they are, as gynecologists, are observing a lot an increasing in primary amenorrhea and also in the precox menarca, okay, the first menstruation, that is appearing very, very early. And maybe it's for the nutrition and a lot of estrogen and also environment distress. Secondary amenorrhea is different.
It's different. But, ma sempre. L'intervento sull'asse psiconeuro trova alla base melatonina e io metto sempre beta-endorfina, più l'anti-stress.
Yeah, it's always important to act on the psycho-neuro part of the stress axis. Sometimes when your patient are a little dysregulated by a neurovegetative point of view, anti-age stress is very useful.
Mantenendo ovviamente il suo drenaggio, perché è una cosa sacrosanta.
Always Guna matrix, you know, it's our Bible. The same Guna fan, but something change also.
In questo caso, riteniamo, sto parlando, è un'esperienza anche comune a molti colleghi, confronto, è proprio il caso di affiancare il farmaco generale con l'utilizzo del ormone singolo.
That's interesting. When you have a secondary amenorrhea, always you use FEM for the general PMEI rebalancing, but we can enhance the activity of FEM with two specific hormones.
Yes. Perché se vogliamo, also the use of melatonin, is a straightening action of Guna Fem, because in Guna Fem there is also difference.
Yeah.
But the single hormone is very important in this.
And
let me look.
No, I had a question for you. There is a particular timing to give beta estradiol and progesterone.
Perfect. I was saying,
good.
From the 14th day of the mouse, of the cycle, because in the luteal phase, after hypothetic ovulation.
Okay.
Per mimare l'andamento naturale della ciclo ormonale.
Makes sense to give progesterone after the 14th day to support the physiological cycle. But the problem is, if the patient has amenorrhea, how do you know which is the 14th day? Se lei in amenorrhea, come fai a sapere i giorni del ciclo?
Ovviamente fai gli esami del sangue, del sangue per 3 giorni con quella metodica. Valuti e a un certo punto decidi.
Okay, since the patient is in amenorrhea, you cannot know when she will be at the 14th day. Mm-hmm. That's the case to take the blood for 3 days, always at the same time to see the hormonal trend. And then you decide, okay, from this moment, I become the clock. I become, and I start giving progesterone. Exactly.
Yeah, but, abbiamo anche un aiuto.
Come?
Abbiamo un aiuto.
But we have an help.
Ecografia.
Or you have also two, you can use ultrasound.
Ultrasound.
Ultrasound, ecography. Ultrasound.
Un po' di casistica in fotografia. Amenorrea, un caso recentissimo. Due casi recentissimi, tra l'altro uno medico. Endometrio, le ovaie, frise, congelate, come in fase luteale, da 6 mesi.
This case is very nice. Patient with secondary amenorrhea, through ultrasound exam, ovary and uterus, endometrius, freeze in luteal phase.
Yes.
So always, always luteal phase.
On, about 8 millimeters. It's like a luteal phase. Follicular maturation. Often on monolateral, only one side. But I had I have two recent cases.
Okay.
And I resolved it with this, and I began to give endorphin.
Anyway, it's
three months.
Okay, for 3 months, and this case has been solved.
It's done now, Mr. Wayne.
And they have the menstruation now, no problem.
But have their fertility. I mean, you could make them bleed, but have their fertility.
No, non ho capito
neanch'io.
Well, you could make them bleed with manipulating hormones, but have their fertility. Are they maturing eggs?
Ah, sì, yes. Follicular maturation.
Yeah.
You can see, yes. They have.
With the ultrasound.
They have.
What about if the reason for the secondary amenorrhea is anorexia? Is there anything different to consider?
Yes, in anorexia, yes. We are in this problem.
Exactly.
This side of the problem. At this side of the problem, we have the abbiamo la interferenza con I ormoni della tiroide e insulina.
Okay. In patient with anorexia, we are on this side of the problem, and also remember that in anorexia you have an interference with thyroid and pancreas hormones
and
adrenals. Anyway, the problem is that especially leptin doesn't push the production of GnRH, so you lose the pulsatility. So to reestablish the pulsatility, always remember melatonin and beta endorphin. So makes sense in anorexia, sustaining secondary amenorrhea, even more melatonin and beta endorphin. The problem is that the fat cells are not able to push the GnRH pulsatility. Okay? The same in patients, in athletes, in donne atlete.
Yes.
So, it's here the problem. You can help them with melatonin and beta endorphin.
And how could you monitor that? Like, my people anorexia now are on the pill because they also have osteoporosis.
Okay, le sue pazienti con anorexia, menorrea dovuta anorexia sono sotto estroprogestinici, anche perché hanno problemi di osteoporosi. So,
certo.
cosa puoi fare tu? Qual è il tuo suggerimento in questo tipo di paziente?
Ok, parleremo dopo dell'osteoporosi, ma gli estroprogestinici, the pills, servono to kill the...
Ok, Maurizio doesn't agree with the use of estroprogestinics, the pills. contraceptive pills, not for contraception, but for treatment.
The problem is also the age of the
patients.
It's different. The problem is different in the adolescent or in 48.
21.
She's 21.
Gli estroprogestinici sono una forzatura.
It's better perché not.
Non esiste a 21 anni una problematica di osteoporosi da dover combattere a 3 mesi o 6 mesi. Cioè si può aspettare.
Non ho capito.
Allora, voglio dire, a 21 anni.
When you are 20,
21.
When the patient is 21 years old, doesn't
there is not the urge to give the
okay, I translate that doesn't exist the urgency to give estroprogestinics because she's very young, so the condition of the bones.
His T-score of -3 is very bad.
She's in a very bad condition. Even though she's 21.
Yeah. Allora, ok, va bene. Potenziamo l'azione degli estroprogestinici con questo braccio della.
In that case, since you say it's she's in a very bad situation, you cannot avoid estroprogestinic, but it's better to enhance with that part of the therapy.
Però c'è un problema. Possiamo continuare a parlare?
Yes.
Però c'è un problema.
But there is a problem.
How long is the
in italiano, Maurizio?
Da quanto tempo è in come si chiama? Anoressia.
How long she is an anorexic?
3 years.
3 years.
3 years. Yeah.
And so from 18. From 18, and how long takes up the estroprogestin?
6 months.
E se c'è la necessità di darlo, però a questo punto è importante un appoggio di questo braccio, perché è potente e puoi riuscire a sospendermi. Allora, finché.
Ok, traduco. Okay. Maurizio is quite reluctant to use estroprogestinic in young people for that reason. Anyway, the situation is very severe, so okay, but please enter with FEM, with estradiol and progesterone, and week after week try to reduce the administration of estroprogestinic. Otherwise, there is the risk to lose that patient, lose in terms of endocrine activity.
Finché prende gli estroprogestinici sarà sempre in aminorrea, realmente.
Also because since she will be under estroprogestinic, she will be always under aminorrhea. So you will not solve the problem of aminorrhea.
No, that wasn't the problem. She actually stopped the osteoporosis and worry about that.
So the problem, she started with the estroprogestinic to treat the osteoporosis. Yes. Now the problem, obviously, is the aminorrhea, and she wants also not to have aminorrhea. So the only possibility is to reduce estroprogestinic, keeping under control for the osteoporosis with that scheme, but in the same time, maybe aminorrhea will disappear. It's an overlapping therapy.
Yeah, thank you. Sorry.
No, that's very interesting. Thank you very much for your questions.
Thank you for the question. Well, and dismenorrea? Dismenorrea? Allora, sotto la voce di dismenorrea, io vorrei indicare tutte le sindrome dolorose della pelle.
Okay. Under the term dismenorrea, Maurizio would like to put together all those diseases that are under the umbrella of pelvic pain syndromes. It's okay? So, pelvic pain syndrome is dysmenorrhea.
Questo, dal punto di vista dell'inquadramento, ma anche della terapia.
This is important both in terms of diagnosis, but for some common parts for the therapy.
Dismenorrea primaria. Il dolore ovviamente causato dalle contrazioni uterine. Ma qui vediamo un aggancio subito al sistema immunitario, un aumento di produzione di prostaglandine.
That's very interesting that pain is caused by spasm, and why spasm? There is an abnormal answer of the endometrium to prostaglandins and prostacyclin stimulation. So Maurizio says, look, once again, it's not an hormonal problem, it's an endocrine immune problem.
Yes.
Once again, a PNEI problem. That's interesting.
Qui siamo ancora nel campo della normalità.
It's quite normal to have a little dysmenorrhea. I think that women doesn't agree with you.
No, della normalità, cosa intendo? No, con tutto il rispetto, della normalità non c'è, è un problema di variazione di intensità.
It's interesting. It's not normal, but it's the problem is the intensity and
la variazione dell'intensità del dolore, sia della risposta alle prostaglandine, sia della liberazione delle prostaglandine, sia della soglia di sensibilità.
Ok, so. So Maurizio says the problem is that it's quite physiological, this mechanism. What is pathological is the sensitivity of some women to the effect of these prostaglandins. So we have to act also on that sensitivity.
In quest'ottica, variando l'intensità di risposta, variando l'intensità dell'alterazione delle prostaglandine, e quindi a monte ci sono le citochine, possiamo inserire tutti gli aspetti del dolore pelvico fino all'endometriosi.
Okay. So, since prostaglandins are stimulated by some cytokines, we can modulate the prostaglandins and the sensitivity to prostaglandins of that woman acting on the cytokines with the approach we know. No, it's because in English, in Italian, we use 100 words to say something, in English, 3. So, you must be very simple. Since we are speaking about hormones, when you like a woman, Maurizio, what do you say? Ah, you are beautiful. They say, I want to have sex with you. Boom, go. English is very... You start with roses, dinners. No.
So you should have sex after dinner.
We are romantic.
The focus is... Tutti i dolori pelvici sono
This morning we spoke a lot about inflammation. Maurizio says, remember, all the pelvic pain syndromes, including dysmenorrhea, are due to an alteration, adenomyosis, fibromatosis, and so endometriosis are inflammatory diseases. So yes, take a look at the hormones, but also at the cytokines, that's the new.
Il confine è vicino.
The border is very close.
Molti aspetti dello stesso problema.
Inflammation.
La nostra proposta terapeutica.
Tutto.
Ok, perfetto. Avete tutto. Ricordiamo remember the drainage,
why lymph and not matrix in PMS?
perché la componente dell'impegno linfatico è maggiore, qui siamo a contatto di un'infiammazione generalizzata soprattutto delle sirose e delle l'endometrio è una cosa.
Ok.
Un'ultima cosa? Sì. L'adenomiosi, endometrio, sì. Quindi muscolare, nelle fibre muscolari dell'utero, è una cosa.
Ok. Please. Take note of this in PMS Guna lympho, because since the involvement of the mucosa is very strong, is lympho that is able to drain better than matrix. The histological structure of those tissues, mucosal tissues, are better treated by lympho.
And cirrhosis, uterus.
Okay, there is an involvement of mucosa and serosa, seros.
Uterus. Endometrium. Adenomiosis. Endometrium between is a border from endometriosis, of course. Endometrium in the muscular fibers of the uterus. Peritoneum. Serosas. Lympho, Guna lympho is more specific than Guna matrix. You can use both.
Yeah, anyway, makes sense, absolutely. The involvement of lymphatic vessels in those mucosal and serosal tissues is much, much important. Good.
Good.
Tutto.
In a mood, when there is a mood instability, una componente di interferenza psiconeuro, questa è l'asse, ricordiamo, dello psiconeuro.
These are the medications that Maurizio recommend to you, especially to act on the psychoneural level, obviously Guna mood for mood instability, and PMS, always work on the high part, okay? And beta endorphin, now we know because of the pulsatility.
Possiamo anche introdurre, abbiamo già un buon affermo.
Always
buon affermo. Raccomandato il progesterone o anche la melatonina in associazione.
Okay.
La scelta del medico, non possiamo imporre tutto. Queste sono, ci sono alcuni farmaci cardine. Gli altri sono opzioni.
Okay, Maurizio is saying that some of these medications are mandatory, lympho, FEM, and PMS. Very interesting. And very interesting is the use of progesterone for the management of the pain, obviously after the 14 day. And all the other, according to the picture of the specific patient.
For the pain, progesterone for the pain and eventually for the bleeding or alteration of bleeding. Maybe 14 during the...
Okay, and with progesterone you will be in the position also to manage the spotting.
So, ecco. L'hai già descritta tu stamattina, no. Ecco, è un farmaco importantissimo.
This is a very important medication.
Mi permetto di
sottolineare
di enfatizzare alcune cose. Revelance of play access.
Maurizio likes PMS for the presence of melatonin or and hypophysis. So we are working on the upper part of the PNPI axis.
It's very important also la, anche la stabilizzazione neurovegetativa.
Okay, that you have to act on the neurovegetative stabilization that is always lost in this type of patient. You will work on hot flashes.
Yeah. Equilibrio endocrino. Equilibrio endocrino, estrogeni, progesterone, l'estratto di ovaio, della granulosa della granulosa dell'ovaio, poi nell'ipofisi. Era grande possibilità e capacità di modulare e ridurre i sintomi, che sono quelli per cui le pazienti vengono da noi.
And beside the rebalance of the PMPI axis, also consider remedies like magnesium phosphoricum that in homeopathy is typical of the
muscular.
Exactly, the spasm and camomilla, for instance.
Contrazione muscolare, contrazione dell'utero, come abbiamo visto prima. Lo stimolo delle prostacicline modulate da progesterone, farmaci miorilassanti, rimedi miorilassanti.
And the prostacycline and prostaglandin are modulated by progesterone. So the presence of progesterone really is absolutely interesting in this medication. So it is already effective, and you can enhance the activity of Guna PMS with single other hormones, for instance.
E direi che è un farmaco completo per gestire tutti gli aspetti, tutte le facce.
Yeah.
Poi può essere a scelta, a seconda della paziente, perché i protocolli sono utili, ma più importanti sono le pazienti.
It is the North Star of the therapy, and you have to use in all your patients Guna PMS, and according to the differences of each patient, you can add the other remedies that are progesterone, melatonin, beta endorphin, melatonin plus beta endorphin when you have some disturbances in the pulsatility. Maybe Guna Lympho always, because there is this gravitational.
The mandatory, I think, are PMS, lympho,
and FEM.
The other you can choose.
Ancillary. Supporting.
This is a repetition, but ma ho introdotto per la componente infiammatoria, quando il dolore è sostenuto da una componente infiammatoria marcata, si può fare un imocromo, ma è sufficiente, una PCR, proteina C reattiva, CPR, reactive C protein, interleuchina, anti-interleuchina.
Ok, when there is a evident inflammatory conditions, how to understand that even through blood test is sufficient CRP, okay, C-reactive protein, to understand that there is an inflammation, and in this case you already know very well Guna anti-interleukin 1 is the drug to consider for that aspect.
Syndrome dell'ovario policistico.
Policystic ovary syndrome, another interesting disease that we can manage very well.
Come sappiamo tutti, la sindrome dell'ovario policistico può essere ipotizzata, se non diagnosticata, anche guardando la paziente.
Sometimes it is sufficient to look at the patient to understand that maybe she is living a PCOS.
Ovviamente non esiste bianco e nero, ma esistono tanti grigi.
No. It's an Italian
phrase.
Sometimes it's not so definite that you look at, okay, she has PCOS. They are some nuances of
some
gray that you have to understand.
Some characteristics you can hypothesize the presence in any micro. Disordini metabolici, sovrappeso, obesità, intolleranza alla intolleranza glicidica e spesso, andando avanti con l'età, patologie cardiovascolari.
Maurizio is underlining that PCOS is a systemic disease. And we don't know if it is provoked by metabolic disorders or if provoke metabolic disorders. Anyway, we don't have to ignore this problem because sometimes it can sustain cardiovascular diseases and so on.
Yeah. Caratteristiche cliniche. Quindi abbiamo fattori genetici. Scusatemi, sto sottolineando questi aspetti che certo conoscete tutti, ma come domanda, non come risposta.
Okay, Maurizio is stressing this concept that you already know, but he wants to start from this part. So he starts. First of all, there is a part that is genetic.
Yes. Anormalità dei recettori dell'insulina.
Always there is an insulin resistance due to a downregulation of insulin transmembrane receptors.
Alterazione del rapporto FSH-LH.
And very important, by the endocrine point of view, you have the inversion of the ratio FSH-LH. Normally, it's higher FSH and lower LH. In those patients, it's higher LH and lower FSH.
In fase follicolare.
In follicular phases, obviously.
Ma queste cose le conoscete tutte.
But you already know that. But maybe not all of you knows these references.
Fertility and Steriliti, 2012. Fertility and Steriliti, è una rivista molto...
Okay, in 2012, Fertility and Steriliti, that is the... wait a second. Is the referring journal for all the gynecologists working in the field of fertility, says that... an inflammatory process with question mark, but we can erase the question mark for sure.
No,
as it is.
È il titolo della
pubblica. Yeah, yeah. It's interesting. Look, once again, inflammation, inflammation, inflammation.
Questo è il titolo di questo articolo. Alterazione di proteine reattive, interleukina 18.
And we have a lot of objective markers of inflammation in PCOS patients, such as C-reactive protein, interleukin 18. Look, that interleukin 18 is the same overexpressed in psoriasis also, and monocyte chemoattractant protein 1, and so on. So, systemic inflammatory disease.
Ancora. Una situazione di infiammazione cronica generalizzata, ormai è accertata, dal punto di vista di chi si occupa di medicina riproduttiva.
So, we know that...
associati alla sindrome dell'ovaio policistico o è la sindrome dell'ovaio policistico che si manifesta in un quadro di infiammazione di basso grado generalizzata?
So, for sure, inflammation is involved. Now we don't know if it is PCOS provoking inflammation, generalized inflammation, or a low-grade chronic inflammation, the onset for PCOS. Anyway, there is this involvement.
Volevo sottolineare come le situazioni siano lavori molto recenti.
Maurizio wants to show. It's really something recent.
E ancora. You can read the
many references about the relationship between inflammation and PCOS.
E ancora. Ma non c'è tuttora, lo leggete meglio di me, un consenso su un trattamento risolutivo per la sindrome dell'ovaio policistico. Abbiamo tanti modi diversi di affrontare il problema a seconda delle varie specialità da cui la paziente è visitata.
There is not a generalized consensus for the therapy of PCOs. But because the endocrinologists treat the PCOs in a way, the gynecologists in another way. Anyway, maybe there is a common matrix for every treatment, and it is referred to the treatment of inflammation.
Prego di osservare la data e il livello della rivista di referenza.
This is really something very updated, the mainstream reproduction 2015.
Quindi, problema genetico, alterazione del profilo ormonale, ma un aspetto di infiammazione cronica di basso grado?
All of those are part of a puzzle. We absolutely have to consider the whole picture.
Yes. Good. Non c'è un'infiammazione. Vabbè, you can read in English better. The problem is that there is not a consensus. At the state of the art. Al momento non esiste un completo consenso sul tipo di terapia di approccio alla sindrome dell'ovario policistico. Però abbiamo avuto dei dati sperimentali con terapia a bassa dose.
Okay, this is one of the study conducted by the University of Milan with the use of low dose hormones in treatment of an animal model of PCOs. Very interesting, because it's the model normally used to study this disease.
Caso controllo.
Okay, you can see in this case the quantity of healthy follicles before and after treatment with the Guna hormones. These are 100% of follicles expressed if you have a PCOS, if you had a PCOS now treated with the hormones that Maurizio will tell you.
Yes, l'aspetto dei follicoli, la caratteristica diagnostica della sindrome dell'ovario policistico è il numero di follicoli superiore a 5 di diametro di un centimetro. Comunque, there's not a problem.
Yeah, the problem in PCOS is that there are cystic follicles.
I follicoli cistici sono diminuiti, qui manca il P, era P uguale 0,05.
Absolutely significant, yeah. And the cystic follicles decreased after treatment with, it was progesterone and FSH, low dose Guna.
Lui ha seguito.
Yeah. So.
The p-value, this study is for the p-value that was less than 5%.
The p-value was 0.05, so statistically significant.
Un altro parametro, il progesterone del siero, controllo, idea più low dose.
So, you can observe as providing progesterone in low dose, you increase the progesterone. And we wanted to increase the progesterone to downregulate the hyperestrogenism.
E così pure la diminuzione degli estrogeni.
And the estrogens went down. So, by a pharmacological effectiveness, low dose hormones are
low dose
significant hormone effective.
Sono stati misurati, è stato misurato con significatività statistica da un istituto universitario l'effetto farmacologico degli ormoni low dose.
So, no question that low dose hormones worked well, such as pharmacological concentration of hormones. And before the break, this is the scheme to treat PCOS.
Okay.
Ho alcuni pazienti che sono state trattate, ho avuto degli ottimi risultati, purtroppo non, per brevità non ho portato la casistica, se no saremmo stati qui per due giorni.
Okay, Maurizio wants just to say that he has in treatment and he already treated a good number of patients with PCOS with this scheme, and they all of them had the remission of the symptomatology and of the picture of PCOS.
Okay,
lympho. Remember always that when you have to drain this part, lympho is better than matrix.
Guna fem.
Fem to reestablish a good PNEI reprogramming.
Qui utilizziamo gli ormoni singoli in rinforzo.
In this case it's absolutely mandatory the use of single hormones with this timing.
FSH, FSH, from first to 7 days, then progesterone.
From the 14th to the 28th day. It's very important. This is very nice, this scheme, because Maurizio told you that in PCOS you have FSH low and LH too high. So giving FSH, you restore the good level. Progesterone. Progesterone is the opposite of LH. So you down-regulate estrogens, and also progesterone is to fight the hyperestrogenism of these patients. So it's absolutely very physiological.
I suggest always melatonin. We can put on this side because act both on somatic and on psychoneural.
Always Maurizio like to use the melatonin, you remember, to control the GnRH. So it's very complete this way.
Melatonin, but come abbiamo visto prima, as we saw before, we have literature support. Abbiamo supporti di letteratura.
Absolutely, we are supported by literature about the use of melatonin to act on GnRH. Okay. I think that we have a break for a coffee, and then we go to climacteric symptoms with the experience of Maurizio. Thank you very much.